Campi Flegrei is not the only one. Are other supervolcanoes waking up too? Imagine a peaceful early morning in southern Italy. The sun is rising over the Bay of Naples, fishermen are preparing their boats, and shopkeepers in nearby towns ready for the day. Suddenly, a low rumble shakes the ground. Windows rattle and birds take flight. Beneath the calm surface, a sleeping giant is stirring. This is Campi Flegrei, the Phlegraean Fields, a sprawling volcanic caldera just west of Naples. Lately, it has been making its presence known with swarms of small earthquakes and the steady lifting of the land. For the people living atop this giant, each tremor is a reminder that the earth beneath their feet is very much alive. Campi Flegrei doesn't look like a classic volcano. There's no towering cone like nearby Vesuvius. Instead, it's a broad, gentle depression, about 12 to 14 kilometers, 7 to 8.5 miles across. In fact, if you stroll through the area, you might not realize you're inside a huge caldera formed by ancient super eruptions. 500,000 people live in this volcanic field, which includes bustling towns, the city of Pozzuoli, and even parts of metropolitan Naples. From the ground, it appears as a landscape of rolling hills, steaming fumaroles, and sulfur-smelling hot springs. But deep below, a reservoir of magma and hot fluids has been causing the ground to heave like a breathing beast. Since the 1950s, the coastal town of Pozzuoli has been lifted by nearly 4 meters, 13 feet, about the height of a double-decker bus, due to pressure building underground. The slow rise and fall of the land is known locally as bradyzism, a phenomenon where magma and gases inflating beneath the caldera push the surface upward, only for it to sometimes sink back down when the pressure releases. In recent years, the activity of Campi Flegrei has ramped up, giving scientists both excitement and concern. Starting around 2019, residents began feeling more frequent tremors. By 2023 and into 2024, swarms of earthquakes were shaking the caldera on a regular basis. In one burst of activity in late 2023, over 100 quakes struck in just 2 days, including a magnitude 4.0 tremor, the strongest in 40 years. The people in Pozzuoli woke in the night to cracked walls and falling plaster, some even choosing to sleep in their cars or in tents outside. Schools closed for the day as a precaution. The Italian civil protection authorities didn't take this lightly. They prepared emergency plans and even ran evacuation drills in case the unrest escalates. After all, Campi Flegrei's past reminds everyone why caution is needed. About 39,000 years ago, it unleashed one of the most massive eruptions Europe has ever seen, an event to have influenced the climate and perhaps even contributed to the demise of the Neanderthals. Despite these dramatic signs of unrest, scientists studying Campi Flegrei urge caution against panic. The ground rising about 2 centimeters per month in 2023 to 2024 is a clear sign of pressure below, and the accumulating quakes indicate that parts of the volcano's roof, the caldera crust, are straining. One team of researchers described parts of the volcano as being stretched nearly to breaking point. But breaking doesn't necessarily mean a giant eruption will happen tomorrow. The last eruption here was in 1538 and was relatively minor, though it did form a new little hill, creatively called Monte Nuovo. Campi Flegrei has been restless on and off for more than 70 years now, with notable crises in the 1980s when tens of thousands of people were temporarily evacuated as the ground swelled. Each time, the tension eventually eased without an eruption. Will this current wave of activity follow the same pattern? No one can say for sure. As Campi Flegrei keeps everyone on their toes in Italy, it's natural to wonder, is it unique? Or are other volcano giants around the world waking up too? Well, pack your virtual bags. Our next stop is across the Mediterranean in the Aegean Sea to a picturesque island that holds an explosive secret. The Greek island of Santorini is known for its stunning whitewashed houses clinging to the cliffs above a sparkling blue sea. Tourists flock to enjoy sunsets over the caldera, often unaware that they are standing on the rim of a massive volcanic crater, created by one of the biggest eruptions in human history. Around 3,600 years ago, Santorini, then known as Thera, literally blew its top in the famous Minoan eruption. The Bronze Age blast may have devastated the Minoan civilization across the Aegean and given rise to the legend of Atlantis sinking beneath the waves. the island's center collapsed into the emptied magma chamber, and seawater rushed in, leaving a ring of islands. The remnants of the volcano's walls encircling a deep lagoon. Today, Santorini's peaceful postcard beauty belies a fiery past. Lately, however, Santorini has felt some faint rumbles of its own. In early 2025, Greek officials and scientists held emergency meetings after the island was shaken by a swarm of tiny earthquakes. Dozens of quakes, most of them too small to cause damage, clustered underneath the northern part of the caldera. Locals and tourists likely didn't feel more than a slight tremor, but seismic instruments picked up the flurry of activity. Was this volcano, quiet since 1950, getting ready for a new act? Experts pointed out that Santorini has been through similar unrest before without an eruption. So, what's happening now? The recent mini quakes might be the volcano's way of letting off steam, so to speak. Geologists think they could be caused by small amounts of magma or hot fluids shifting deep underground, cracking rocks as they move. Santorini is closely monitored by the Institute of Geodynamics in Athens and other scientific teams. They measure everything from earthquake swarms to ground deformations using GPS and satellite. As of the latest reports, Santorini's activity is elevated but still within what volcanologists call unrest rather than an imminent eruption. In other words, the volcano is murmuring in its sleep, not roaring awake. No discussion of supervolcanoes is complete without talking about Yellowstone in the United States. Yellowstone's reputation precedes it. It's often hyped in movies and media as a doomsday volcano that could blanket the continent in ash. Indeed, this giant caldera, which spans part of Wyoming, Montana, and Idaho, was born from colossal eruptions in the distant past. The ground we visit as a national park today sits atop an enormous volcanic system that has had three super eruptions in the last 2.1 million years. Two of those eruptions, around 1.3 million and 631,000 years ago, each spewed out more than 1,000 cubic kilometers of material, enough to qualify as true supervolcano events. Those explosions left behind giant depressions. The latest caldera is roughly 50 by 80 kilometers across, about 30 by 50 miles. If you stand at the Yellowstone Lake or drive through Hayden Valley, you are actually inside the vast volcanic caldera, though it's so big you won't see its edges easily. Despite its explosive history, Yellowstone today is a gentle giant, at least in human timescales. Millions of visitors safely enjoy its geysers and hot springs each year. The volcano beneath gurgles in size, but it hasn't had any lava erupt at the surface for about 70,000 years. Is Yellowstone waking up? The answer from scientists is a reassuring no, not in the way people might fear. Yes, it's active, the ground rises and falls a little. There are thousands of small earthquakes each year, mostly too small to feel. Geysers like Old Faithful keep spouting, driven by underground heat. These are signs of a living volcanic system, but none are extraordinary for Yellowstone. In fact, the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory keeps a constant eye on the giant and reports that current activity is background level. For example, in the year 2024, around 1,100 earthquakes were recorded in the Yellowstone region, which is actually on the low side of average. Sometimes, the caldera floor lifts a few centimeters for a few years, then gently subsides. A normal breathing cycle of the magma reservoir below. Scientists have also peered deep into Yellowstone's belly using advanced techniques. Their findings? There's a lot of hot, partly molten rock down there, as expected. But it's not a single huge molten lake ready to erupt. Instead, it's more like a sponge of hot, mostly solid rock with pockets of melt. Crucially, these pockets of magma are mostly disconnected from each other and from deeper magma sources. Without a connected, expanding magma chamber, an eruption has nothing to fuel it. One Yellowstone scientist used a vivid analogy. Right now, Yellowstone's magma burner is turned off. The system is not heating up towards an eruption. Aside from Campi Flegrei, Santorini, and Yellowstone, are other supervolcanoes stirring? The answer is yes. On occasion, several caldera volcanoes worldwide have shown signs of unrest. Each has its own personality and rhythm, but all remind us that Earth's crust is dynamic. In New Zealand, the beautiful Lake Taupo sits in a caldera created by a massive eruption about 26,500 years ago, the Aru Anui eruption, one of the few true super eruptions known. That event was colossal, blowing out around 1,170 cubic kilometers of material and leaving a huge hole in the ground that is now filled by Lake Taupo. In recorded history, Taupo had a violent eruption around the year 232 CE, which darkened skies as far as Rome, according to some Chinese and Roman records, though that eruption was much smaller than the super eruption before. Recently, between mid-2022 and 2023, Taupo showed unusual unrest. Over 1,800 small earthquakes were detected under the lake during that period, the highest number in decades. The lake bed itself and the surrounding land lifted slightly due to magma or fluids moving below. In November 2022, a strong magnitude 5.7 quake even struck beneath the lake, causing a mini tsunami that sloshed the lake's waters onto shore by 40 meters in places. For the first time ever, New Zealand scientists temporarily raised Taupo's alert level to 1, on a scale where 0 means background calm, to signal this heightened unrest. Thankfully, by mid-2023, the quakes calmed down and the ground stabilized, and Taupo was lowered back to alert level 0. No eruption occurred, which is what usually happens during these restless periods. But the episode gave researchers valuable data on how Taupo's caldera behaves. It's a reminder that even after tens of thousands of quiet years, a volcano can stretch its limbs a bit. Moving to Indonesia, we find the granddaddy of all supervolcanoes, Toba. About 74,000 years ago, Toba produced an eruption of almost unimaginable scale, the largest known eruption on Earth in the past 2 million years. It blasted out an estimated 5,000 cubic kilometers of volcanic material, leaving behind a caldera 100 kilometers long, now occupied by Lake Toba. Ash from that eruption has been found all across Asia and even as far as Africa. For a long time, scientists thought this eruption caused a volcanic winter that nearly drove humanity extinct. New studies suggest the climate effects, while severe, weren't uniformly catastrophic for early humans. But there's no doubt it must have been a rough time on the planet. Today, Toba is quiet on the surface. Its last eruption was around 500 AD, rather small. But underneath, it still emits heat and gases. It's monitored by Indonesian and international teams. Other calderas worth mentioning include the Long Valley caldera in eastern California, which had a series of strong earthquakes and ground uplift in the 1980s that alerted scientists and led to years of careful observation. Long Valley's big blast happened around 760,000 years ago, the Bishop Tuff eruption, and while it had some magma movement during the 1980s unrest, it eventually quieted without an eruption. In Japan, the Aira caldera, home to the active Sakurajima volcano, is another restless caldera that frequently burps ash and lava, though on a smaller scale. There's also Laguna del Maule in Chile, which has been steadily rising at an astonishing rate, almost 20 centimeters per year at one point, over the last decade. A sign magma is pooling below, but it too has not erupted in many centuries. Each of these cases underscores that waking up can be a slow and subtle process for supervolcanoes. We've been using the term supervolcano, but what does it actually mean? Supervolcano isn't a strict scientific classification, like the way we categorize earthquakes by magnitude. It's more a casual term that caught on to describe volcanoes capable of the most gigantic eruptions. Scientists often define a supervolcano eruption as one that ejects over 1,000 cubic kilometers, that's 1 trillion cubic meters, of ash, pumice, and lava in one go. By educating ourselves about these natural phenomena, we can replace helpless fear with informed respect. Supervolcanoes are indeed super, super big, super powerful, and super interesting. They connect geology with history. Think of how Santorini's eruption changed ancient cultures, and with future human planning and safety. So the next time you read a headline about Volcano X is waking up, you'll know the context. It might be stirring, yes, but there's a whole scientific team awake and watching it, ready to keep the sleeping giant in check. So what do you think about these supervolcanoes? Which one do you think might erupt first?